There were a host of diseases that I had never seen before, that I had only read about or maybe had seen 1 to 2 cases. And these were primarily infectious diseases and tropical disease. I think I had seen 2 cases of measles during my residency. And I recall one of the cases, they actually called every person in the hospital to come see this because it's so rare these days in developed countries to see measles. After having worked in Nigeria, I saw about maybe 250 cases by the end, and in Sierra Leone continued to see many cases. And so it was really interesting to me to learn about all of those protocols and to also, you know, see firsthand the detrimental effects that can happen from a disease that's very, very preventable. So I've actually used that in my practice now. I'm actually able to tell people, you know, especially mothers who are refusing vaccinations, my own personal experience with seeing a disease that we have a vaccine, a very effective vaccine for, and all of the detrimental effects that can happen afterwards, such as blindness, such as severe pneumonia and death. So it's actually come into play in my own practice now. You're provided with 2 books. One is a green book and a white book that describe the protocols and the drugs that you can use for these diseases. So if you're not familiar, that's definitely a good first step in the right direction. But I think that at the end of the day, it really comes down to your clinical acumen and your experience before, and that the protocols will give you a framework to work within and will help you with treating, you know, 90-95% of the patients. But just as in the US, there's always going to be that patient that doesn't quite fit into the mold. And that's where, for me, being able to speak to other colleagues, being able to sort of think outside of the box a little bit, really helped, because there's some patients who, if you follow the protocols, they still might not improve, and you really have to sort of get back to your clinical diagnostic skills, because you don't have the luxury of having being able to send off, you know, tens of labs. You don't have the luxury of being able to image. So you really have to sort of think, is there something else complicating this that could explain why this patient is not responding to the appropriate protocol, for example, for cerebral malaria or what have you.